How to submit tax info on Google AdSense for non-US YouTubers. Welcome everyone, in this tutorial, I will show you step by step how to fill and set up tax information for creators outside the US. So filing the tax information in Google AdSense for YouTube is very crucial. And according to Google, if you don't submit US tax information, then 24% of your all YouTube ad revenue will be deducted by Google and US. But if you file and complete your YouTube AdSense tax forms, then you have to pay 15% or less, or even 0% tax, depending on the tax treaty between your country and United States and its rates. And that's only applicable for views that come from United States. So for example, let's say you are a creator in India and you earn $1,000 in a month from YouTube, and from that $400 comes from US viewers, then 15% of $400, which will be $60, will be withheld for US taxes, and the remaining $600 earned from viewers outside the US will not be subject to US withholding tax. So tax treaty can significantly reduce the amount of US tax withheld from your YouTube earnings. So it is crucial to understand the specific tax treaty between your country and the United States and properly claim those benefits when providing your tax information to Google. Now first of all, you have to check if your country has any tax treaty with United States or not, and you can check it on the official IRS website. I will leave a link to it in the description. You can check whether your country has a tax treaty with the US or not. And if your country has a tax treaty with the United States and you want to know what is the rate, I will also include a link in the description. You can check the rates for your countries. Now here you can see I am from India, and here the tax rate is 15%. That means 15% of my YouTube revenue that comes from US viewers will be deducted. And if I don't fill US tax information, then 24 to 13% of my all YouTube revenue that's come from all countries will be deducted by Google. So it's very important to fill the tax information. And if your country doesn't have a tax treaty with the USA, then Google may be required to withhold up to 13% of your YouTube income that comes from US viewers. And for that as well, you have to submit your tax information on your Google AdSense account for YouTube. So first of all, what are you gonna do? Log into your Google AdSense account. And here on the homepage of your AdSense account, at the very top, you will get a notification prompting there's something important to check in your AdSense account if any additional tax information is required from you. And all YouTube creators and partners are actually required to submit tax information to ensure any applicable taxes on your payments are accurate. So once you get this notification, here just click on Manage Tax Info. And now you will be in this page. And if you don't see that notification, then you can come to this page by clicking on Payments and Payments Info on the left section. And now under Settings, you have to click on Manage Settings. And here if you scroll down, under Address and Phone Number, you can find the United States Tax Info option. So here you have to click on the pencil icon. And then you have to click on Manage Tax Info. And that will bring you to the same page. Now here right to United States, you will have Add Tax Info option. So here click on Add Tax Info. And now in this menu, click on Start Form. Now to continue submitting your US tax info, you might be required to verify your Google account. So here enter the password of your Google account. And click on Next. And complete your two-step verification. And you will be landed on the page where you can fill and submit your United States tax info. Now in the page of United States tax info, first you have to select the type of account that you have. So if you have a business account, your YouTube channel is actually from a company or you work for that company, then here you have to select on non-individual. But if you have your own YouTube channel, if you just run your YouTube channel by yourself, here you have to select individual. And this is what most of people gonna be selecting. So now here select on individual and click on Next. Now if you are from United States, then here you have to select on Yes, and if you are not a citizen or resident of US, then here you have to select No. And as this tax form is for non-US creators, here select on No, and again click on Next. Now you have to select the type of tax form. As you are not from United States, here you have to select W-8 tax form type. And as under type of account you have selected individual, here you have to select W-8BEN form, and this form is most commonly used by non-US individuals. So this is for individual accounts, but if you have a business account, then you have to select on the second form, which is W-8ECI. But as you are doing it for your own YouTube channel, here select on W-8BEN form, and after that click on Start W-8BEN form. And now you'll start filling W-8BEN tax form for non-US individuals, in which first you will have to fill the tax identity information. Now first you have to enter your full legal name, and remember to enter the same name that is found on your legal documents. And under it you will have DBA name and disregarded entity as optional, so you have to leave this field. Now here you have to select your country of citizenship. So here let me select my country. Now once you selected your country, next you have to enter taxpayer identification number, aka TIN. TIN is an identification number that the IRS requires pays to provide for some tax forms. If you are claiming a tax treaty, like if your country has tax treaty with the United States, here you must provide your foreign TIN number. Now every country has a tax identification number. And in this Google AdSense help page, I will also link it in the description, you can see example of foreign TINs from around the globe. And for India, it is permanent account number, which is PAN. For Indonesia, it is Nomor Pokok Wajib Pajak NPWP. I don't know actually how to pronounce that. For Japan, it is individual number. For Russia, it is taxpayer personal identification number, also known as INN. And for United Kingdom, it is unique taxpayer reference, UTR. And also national insurance number NINO. So this will be different for different country. And here you must provide your foreign TIN number if your country has a tax treaty with the United States. But if your country does not have tax treaty, then as these options are optionals, you can leave this field. Now here let me enter the PAN number under foreign TIN. Once you entered your foreign taxpayer identification number, now here click on next. So once you provided your foreign TIN, now you have to provide your address detail. And here you have to fill your same address which you have filled during AdSense verification. So at first you have to check this box. This is going to be your permanent residence address, where you have your postal address, post office box, all those things. So check on this box and at first make sure your country is selected. And then just enter all your residential address that is found on your government issued ID accurately. Once you filled your address accurately, now here you can check on this box, mailing address is also same as the permanent address. And if it is not, then you can select a different address as mailing address for AdSense. Here I'm gonna check this box as the mailing address is same as my residential address. And then here, let's click on next. And now here is the important part. Now here you have to fill the tax treaty information. So as you can see, India and the US have a tax treaty. If you have selected your country, here you will know if your country has tax treaty with US or not. Under tax treaty, just select on yes if your country has tax treaty with US, and if not, then select on no. As my country has tax treaty with US, I have selected yes. Now once you selected that, under it check on this box, and then again select your country. And now here is the important part. Under special rates and conditions, you have to choose which service you are using. So here you will see three options. The first one is for copyright royalties, such as YouTube partner program, cloud marketplace, reseller model, and PlayPass. Here just select on this checkbox. And under article and paragraph, select on article 12 and paragraph 2AII. And this is the only option you get. And right to it, under withholding rate, you have to select on reduced treaty rate. And here I have to select 15% as India has 15% tax treaty rate with US. If your country has less or even 0%, then here you have to select on that option. Once you selected withholding rate, then under here check on this box. Now let's move on to second option. So for second option, we have services or other business income such as AdSense, but not including AdSense for YouTube. That means it is for website owner. So here check on this box. And under article and paragraph, select on article 7 and paragraph 1. And under withholding rate, here select on 0% reduced treaty rate. As this is not applicable for AdSense for YouTube, so here select on 0%. And again under here, check on this box. And now let's move on to the last option, which is motion picture and TV royalties. So check on this box. And here again select on article 12 and paragraph 2AII. And under withholding rate, again select on reduced treaty rate, which is 15% for my country. And if your country does not have any treaty with US, here you have to select 30% default rate and for the first option as well. So once you selected your withholding rate, now here again click on this checkbox and then click on next. Now under activities and services performed in US, if you performed any activities and services for Google AdSense within United States, and if you want to do it in future, here you can select on yes. But as you just run your YouTube channel, you make videos, Here you have to select on no, and under it you have to check on the box that you certified that the service you provide to Google or its affiliates will be performed solely outside the US, that means in your country, and that any labor or capital, including facilities or tools used to provide such as services, will be physically located outside the US. So here you have to simply select on no and check on this box, because you are a non-US individual and you just make YouTube videos to earn money from ads. So here you have to select on no and then click on next. Now in the next step, under tax reporting, here Google will recommend you to select go paperless, and if you want to get your documents by mail, you have that option here as well. But here we're gonna be selecting the recommended option, which is paperless. And then under here, check on this box that you accept the paperless delivery agreement. And now again, click on next. Now here you will see a document preview information that you have filled, where you can confirm whether you have filled the correct information or not. So here make sure you have provided all your information accurately, and if everything you have provided is correct, now here check on this box that you confirm that you have reviewed the generated tax document to the best of your knowledge and believe that they are true, correct and complete. And again click on next. And now you will reach to the final step, which will be the certification page, where you will be told about the penalties you will get for filing the wrong information. So if you have provided your information everything accurately, here select on this first checkbox under penalties of perjury, I declared that, and here I highly recommend you to give this a read, and here also they have mentioned you will need to submit a new form within 30 days if any certification made on this form becomes incorrect, so you have to keep this in mind. Now once you've done that, under unchanged status affidavit, again check on this box, and here you have to enter a year from 2016 to present. So here you have to actually enter the present year. For example, if you are submitting your tax information in 2025, here you have to select 2025. As I am providing in 2024, here I'm gonna enter 2024. Now just scroll down and under signature, confirm that you are the beneficial owner named in the tax identity section of the tax form. So here you have to select on yes. And here at the bottom, you can see your full legal name. If it is not filled automatically, then here you have to enter your full legal name. So once you've done that, now in this page, click on submit. And if some of your information you have provided does not match what is on your account, now you have to provide additional proof of your document. So here you have to provide a document which exactly matches the information that you have provided on your AdSense account. And the type of file that you can upload is actually PDF, PNG and JPEG. And the document must be less than 15 megapixel. Now in this case, as you can see, I have to upload a proof of residence address. And this verification is needed because for one or more of these three mentioned reasons. And here under document type, I can upload driver's license, passport, taxpayer certificate, and any other government ID and any reasonable written explanation. And here also I can check full list of accepted document. So as we are filling W-8BEN form, let's select on it. And here they have mentioned all the type of document that are accepted. But you can just upload any government issued ID document of your country and it will be accepted. So now let's go back to the previous page. Here I'm gonna upload a Aadhaar card, which is used for proof of residence address in our country. So let me upload it quickly. So I have finished uploading the Aadhaar card. Now let's click on submit documents. And that's it. As you can see, everything is under review. And if you have provided everything accurately, it will be approved in few days. So after 3 weeks, I checked the tax information on Google AdSense, and you can see everything has been approved as I had filled the US tax info correctly. So that's it. That's how you can successfully fill the AdSense tax form if you are a non-US creator. And if this video helps you out, please consider liking this video and if possible leave a comment. I really have put so much efforts into this video. I would greatly appreciate that if you do so. And if you want to know what is the most important step you should do once your channel gets monetized, then watch this video and I will see you in the next one.